to the Second Grace Mass. We are happy to welcome Father Jason, who is our celebrating today. Our opening song is number 701, Think of Mary, number 701.
Take away the sins of the world. Receive our prayer. God, who by the Immaculate Conception of the Blessed Virgin prepared a worthy dwelling for your Son, grant that we pray that as you preserve her from every stain by virtue of the death of your Son, which you foresaw, so through her intercession, we too may be cleansed and admitted to your presence. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen. Thanks be to God.
the angel Gabriel to a town of Nazareth in Galilee with a message for a virgin named
Mary.
Mary, that's right. She was engaged to Joseph from the family of King David. The angel greeted Mary and said, "You are blessed. The Lord is with you." Mary was confused by the angel's words and wondered what they meant. Then the angel told Mary, Don't be afraid. God is pleased with you, and you will have a son. His name will be
Jesus.
He will be great and will be called Son of the Most High. The Lord God will make him king, as his ancestor David was. He will rule the people of Israel forever, and his kingdom will never end. Mary asked the angel, How can this be? How can this happen? I am not married. Then the angel answered, "The Holy Spirit will come down to you, and God's power will come over you. Your son, your child will be called the Holy Son of
God."
Holy Son of
God.
Holy Son of
God.
That's correct. Your relative Elizabeth is also going to have a son, even though she is old. No one thought she could ever have a baby, but in 3 months she will have a son. Nothing is
impossible
for
God.
For who?
God.
Nothing is impossible for
God.
Mary said, "I am the Lord's servant. Let it happen as you have said." And the angel left her. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
All right, have a seat. God is good. Conception mean? Conception, yes ma'am. Not when you give birth, but before birth, giving birth, what happens to a mommy? She has a baby in her? Right, she gets pregnant, right? Like conception, does that have other meanings? Can you conceive an idea in your mind? Right, you can conceive an idea in your mind, right? So, conception means taking form. You can form an idea in your mind. The same way, a young woman, after she's married and she's with her husband, she can conceive a child in her
womb.
Like you and me, we were all once conceived in the womb of our father. We just don't remember that, right? Just don't remember. We're too young for us. And we didn't have our mind fully formed at all. You know, we grow as are born, right? We keep growing after we are born. Let me tell you some joke. Have you ever been to a photographer and the photographer told you not to smile, don't come back until you start smiling? They want you to smile, right? The photographer always says, "Smile, cheese," right? Because when they say cheese, what are you like? Make you smile, right? Well, let me tell you, we had a movie. was born, I'm like, does she even like me? Does she know anybody? Then as she started growing, you know what happened? She started changing every day. Now she's 7 months old, and she knows to say hello or to recognize people and all of that. The other day, they took her to take a picture. And they had to take a picture for the passport, because my nephew is from India, but she's a Canadian baby. Now they have to take a passport, you know? So they brought her to the photographer to take a picture, and guess what? This baby kept smiling and laughing. It looks like yesterday was the day she had laughed. All day, every time. When I called her to the she was laughing. But she had to take a picture for the passport without laughing. The photographer told her daddy after 30 minutes, can't do it today. Take the baby home. Come back when she's not smiling. Have you ever heard a photographer say, come back to take a picture when you're not smiling? So after conceiving, we keep growing, right? So immaculate conception is all about who? Who is being conceived in the womb of the mother?
Mary.
How many of you think it's Jesus? Diana. Oh, you're kind of wrong today. Immaculate conception of the Blessed Mary, the feast we celebrate today, is Mary. But those who lifted your hand first is also correct, because it's also about Jesus. So the baby being formed in the womb is Mary, not Jesus. But why is she being formed in Immaculate? It's because of Jesus. So those of you put up your hand, I've always said you're wrong. You're correct too. Okay, now let's talk about this word called Immaculate. What is that? Immaculate, yes, ma'am. That's right, immaculate means pure, sinless. What sin are we talking about? So in order to understand this piece, we have to go back to the first reading we heard, where we talked about Adam and Eve. Who are those? Who are Adam and Eve?
Don't go looking for it. Only God can give you that, all right?
what? They fell for it. Eve got it. She took a bite. And then she went to Adam and said, hey, try this. Good. And he did it too. All right? He did it too. Then what happened? Sin, right? How did Adam and Eve feel that they were sinful? Soft powder. They felt that they're naked, right? Were they really naked? They felt the absence of God. That's what sin does to us when we disobey God. Just think about it. When you do something bad and go home and you know that mom and dad is going to find out, how do you feel? Bad, right? Are you going to go home and say, Mom, guess what? I did this. Is that where you're going to go? No. When you walk in through that door, your mom knows something happened because you're here, right? Come eat something. No, I don't want. I'm hungry, right? Come play. No, I don't want to play. I'm going to sleep because you have something to hide from mommy, right? You feel bad. That's because you know that you're not the right mom and dad. So Adam and Eve felt naked because they lost the Spirit of God. And then God punished them, put them out of the garden. But as they were leaving the garden, God made them a promise that someday in the future, He will send a Messiah to save us, right? So even when God is punishing them, His mercy, His compassion is with them. Somebody's going to come save them. A new Adam. Somebody who is more loving to God. Somebody who is faithful to God. Somebody who is trustworthy. Who thinks that God is trustworthy. But that did not happen immediately. Alright? And in the future, God is now preparing the time for that new Adam, the Messiah, to come. For Jesus to come. But God had to prepare somebody who is sinless. Well, we have to keep in mind that this too. What is the consequence of Adam and Eve's sin? When they were put out of the garden, everybody who were born after them, through them, also carried that same sin. And that's what we call what? Original sin. Original sin is not something that you do yourself, but you inherited because of the sin of Adam and Eve. Adam and Eve. That's what we call original sin. How did he get rid of the original sin? Through baptism. So in order for us to get to that point of baptism where we can wash away our sins in baptism, somebody had to first take that away for us. And that was Jesus. So Jesus is the Son of God who's coming into the world, and so he could not enter into anything that is sinful. He could not come through a human person, a mommy who carried the original sin in her. And so in preparation for the birth of Jesus, what does God do? He prepares Mary to be born sinless, without the stain of original sin. And God did that just for one person as a favor to make Jesus come to the world. And so Mary is conceived in the womb of her mother and without the stain of original sin. That's what we are celebrating. So the baby that's being conceived is Mary. But it's all about Jesus, because Mary is given that special privilege early in order for Jesus to come to the world. And that's God's way of us. God has already prepared the way for Jesus to come into the world. So everything that is celebrated about Mary or the saints or anybody else in the church, it's all about Jesus. It's about God. It's about participating in the life of Jesus, Son of God. So when Jesus came, He obeyed God. He died on the cross for us. He was perfectly obedient to God and trusted God, unlike the first Adam. So we also call Jesus the second Adam, right? He's a perfect man. And Mary, through her obedience to God, becomes a new Eve. So everybody say, Jesus is the new Adam. And who is the new Eve? Mary. through her obedience when she said, although I don't understand everything perfectly, let your will be done, let God's will be done in my life. So she trusted God, and that's why she became the perfect servant of God. And so what Mary received early in her life, we receive through our baptism. When your mommy and daddy and your godparents stood before the church and denounced Satan and believed in God, and the water was poured on your head, you became a new person. You became like Mary, sinless, all right? Sinless. So in doing that, Mary becomes a model for everybody who wants to be a holy person. Look at Mary, and you understand what it means to believe and trust in God and to be a holy person. Mary is a model of our church, the Holy Catholic Church, what the church should be. When I'm saying church, I'm not talking about a building. Who is the church? You are. The body of Christ means the people who are baptized and believe in God. So she's a model of all of us, how to be holy in life. So, what does this piece teach us about our Christian life? Our God. God is our God, right? So because God is our God, who is a holy God, we all should try to be holy in everything. God has washed away your sins through your baptism. And so you should live as holy people. And so we should always understand that the devil will tempt you to be bad, right? He will deceive you, like he deceived Adam and Eve, like he tried to deceive Jesus. But Jesus never fell for it, right? Because Jesus always told the devil, get behind me, go down, you don't belong here. And Jesus defeated the evil by God's word. Living in obedience to God. So we who are baptized should always know that there's always a chance somebody is going to tempt you. Somebody is going to deceive you. Somebody is going to lead you to sin. So as a child of God, as a holy person, you should always be alert. Your holy antenna should be always alert, right? You should be quick to recognize that somebody is trying to lead me away from God. So one of the best ways to know that somebody is trying to make you sin, you should know the Ten Commandments. Alright? The Ten Commandments. If you know the Ten Commandments, if somebody is asking you to break the Ten Commandments, you know immediately this person is not good for me. Or what they're asking me to do is not good for me. Do everybody know the Ten Commandments? Nice, a good day to begin to learn. Alright? It's not difficult to learn, it's pretty easy. What's the Fourth Commandment? What is the Fourth Commandment?
Obey your parents.
Right. Obey and honor your parents. Right? And I believe that if you know how to obey your parents, you will obey God. You will love God. You will also love and obey others. Because parents are one of the most important defenses in our life. So also your teachers. Do you know that? So treat your teachers also with the same respect and honor as you do your parents. And so when you honor your parents, you will automatically honor your God. You will be a loving person. You won't do anything bad for others. You won't hurt your brothers and sisters, your friends. So that's a good place to be, right? So don't be afraid to do the right thing, or don't be misled by greed. That's what happened to Adam and Eve. When the devil came to him, there were two reasons. They couldn't divide their belt for it. What are those two reasons? One, probably they were afraid, because doing the right thing always is not easy to do, right? When the devil comes, he's a terrible thing. He can cause fear in your heart. Sometimes for us to do the right thing, we have to be courageous. We have to overcome our fear, right? We need courage. Secondly, the other reason why probably they fell for it is, look what the devil said. Hey, God has not given you everything. You will become richer than what you are. You will become like gods. So greed, wanting to have more than what you have. Right? So you have to always keep those two things in mind, not to fall in sin. Greed or fear. Don't be afraid to do the right thing. thee. Don't be greedy for things that you do not have or you don't need. Because those things can always lead you to sin, to be mad. So turn to Mary, the Immaculate Conception, the sinless woman, the model of our life, and always ask her intercession to lead her, to lead you to Jesus, her son. If you turn to Mary, he'll always bring you to who? Jesus. She will always tell you, do as Jesus tells you to do. So shall we say Hail Mary and ask her intercession today? Hail Mary,
full of grace,
the Lord is with thee.
Blessed are you among women, blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. In the name of the Father, of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. All right, being a solemnity, today we also pray the Creed, so everybody please stand. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things are made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. And by the Holy Spirit, was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified in the Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day. In accordance with the Scriptures, he ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord and the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess and baptize some for the forgiveness of sins. I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Now let's offer to God our prayers and petitions.
Silence of our hearts.
help us to be loving and obedient to you like the Blessed Virgin Mary was. And we ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Saving sacrifice which we offer you, O Lord, on the solemnity of the Immaculate Conception of the Blessed Virgin Mary, and grant that as we profess her, on account of your pre-obedient grace, to be untouchable, untouched by any stain of sin, so through her intercession we may be delivered from all our faults, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just our duty and our salvation always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you preserved the most blessed Virgin Mary from all stain of original sin, so that in her, endowed with the rich fullness of a grace, you might prepare a worthy mother for your Son and signify the beginning of the Church. Beautiful bride without spot or wrinkle. She, the most pure Virgin Mary, was to bring forth the Son, the innocent Lamb of God, who wiped away our offenses. You place her above all others to be for your people an advocate of grace and a model of holiness. And so, in company with the chorus of angels, we praise you, and with joy we proclaim. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this all of you and bring from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Michael, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coerced with eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. Amen. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, thank you. Let us pray. May the sacraments we have received, O Lord our God, heal in us the wounds of the fault, from which in a singular way you preserve Blessed Mary in her Immaculate Conception. Through Christ and our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying God by your life.
Thanks be to God.
Closing song is number 206.